Hello and welcome to another episode of A Day in the Kitchen. I'm Mark Daye and today we are making shakshuka. Shakshuka is a Middle Eastern vegetarian dish. It's a tomato salsa with some poached eggs on top. So let's get started. I've got two onions, medium sized. I've got eight Roma tomatoes chopped up, about three or four stalks of celery, one can of diced tomatoes, some olive oil, some salt, six eggs. I've got about six cloves of garlic, some nutmeg, a teaspoon of sugar, and in here is a spice blend, and there is one teaspoon each of turmeric, cumin, hot paprika, chili powder, and garam masala, and then a half teaspoon of cayenne pepper, black pepper, and some hot chili flakes. So to start, we are going to heat some olive oil in our pan, and we're going to saute the onions and the garlic and the celery and all that. So let's just chop up the onions first. This is a really great dish for a lunch or breakfast, and it'll make about six servings. Chop those up, put them right into our pan. Okay, so we're gonna saute that until it's soft. Probably about 5 or 10 minutes, however long it takes. Just get it softened up. So I need to chop up the garlic. What's great about this dish is that it's one pan. You're gonna need a lid for your pan. If you don't have a big skillet, you can use a Dutch oven or something like that as well. And if you don't have a lid, just use a cookie sheet or something that will cover it. You're only covering it at the point when you add the eggs to help them cook. Okay. Okay, we've got all of our garlic and our onion in the pan. We're just gonna cook this until it all softens up. You don't want it to brown, so keep your heat fairly low. And these are starting to soften up now, so I'm gonna go ahead and add the celery. Celery is not a traditional ingredient, but I thought it seemed like it made sense to add it to this, so I'm adding it. Okay, I'm gonna let that cook a couple more minutes and then we'll add all of our dry spices, and we're just gonna heat those on a really low heat and let them become fragrant and sort of bloom those flavors. And after that, then we'll add our tomatoes. Okay, this has been cooking for about 4 or 5 minutes with the celery. So as you can see, the celery is really brightened up. It's starting to cook a bit. So I'm going to go ahead and add my salt. That's kosher salt, and the spice blend. Just put all that in. Give it a stir. It smells fantastic. The onions and garlic, of course, always smell great. And the spice blend is just, it's pretty intense flavor. Just gonna heat that up for about a minute, and that's gonna help your spices to release their fragrance and their flavor. And then we will just go ahead and add all the tomatoes right into that. You can use, you know, if you grow tomatoes, this is a great way to use them up. You can use, I'm using a mixture of fresh and one can, but you could use all fresh, you could use all canned if you don't have fresh tomatoes available. And we're gonna let that cook for about 20, 30 minutes. We want it to be really nice and thick. So let's let this cook down and then we'll come back and we'll finish it up with the eggs. So our shakshuka has been cooking for about 25 minutes, simmering at a low heat. And as you can see, the liquid has reduced quite a bit, but there's still a good amount of liquid left in here. The next thing I'm going to do is add my one teaspoon of sugar. I didn't add it earlier because it might cause it to burn easier, so I just add it at this point. This is reduced quite a bit. We are now going to make sort of a little hole, if you will, and we will add the eggs next. So we've got 6 room temperature eggs. I'm just gonna crack those right in, and you don't wanna break the yolk, and yes, that is a little bit of a shell. And just add all of your eggs. And put as many eggs as the pan will hold. So if your pan will hold 8, put 8. If it'll hold 6, put 6. You know, that sort of thing. So don't break the yolks, and the whites can sort of run into each other, that's fine. And put your last egg right in the middle there. Eggs. Now I like to just add a little bit more salt at this point over top of the eggs and a little bit of pepper on each one. And the last thing I'm going to add is some fresh nutmeg right on top of the eggs there. Okay, so we're just gonna cook this with the lid on now until the eggs are done how you like them. I like the yolks to be runny a bit, but you want the white to be finished. So it's gonna take about another 4 to 5 minutes. We'll come back and show you what it's like when it's all finished. Okay, our eggs have been cooking for about 10 minutes. We're gonna take off the lid and serve it up now. You can cook it longer if you want the egg, the yolk to be firmer, it's up to you. So let's just plate up a bowl here and see what we have. As you can see, it's quite thick. It smells fantastic. It's really hot. And typically you can dress this up with some fresh cilantro, like that. If you don't like cilantro, you could also use parsley or some other fresh herb. That's it, shakshuka, easy one pot meal. All right, let's give it a taste. Mmm, it's really, really good. It's not too hot, but the flavors, that spice blend is really intense and explodes in your mouth. Serve this up with some nice crusty bread or toast. It's a great meal for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. I really hope you give it a try. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. Please share and subscribe if you want. And we'll see you next time in the kitchen.